We're being told or warned that another interest rate rise is likely. The Australian reporting that the Commonwealth Bank has put a shock rate hike next month on the cards. They're saying that inflation isn't going to come down as much as expected. Bronwyn.
Well, there's a couple of really interesting things here to point out. First of all, when you're looking at the commentary on why inflation is rising, it is because immigration is pushing it up. It has become quite apparent that everyone has agreed it is now homegrown inflation. It's not imported from anywhere else. The government is still continuing to spend when it should be reining in expenditure. The RBA only has one tool, and that's interest rates for mortgagees. The pain that they are feeling, and the reality is that when they say that that the pressure in the labour market will become looser, what that means is people will lose their jobs. And if those people are losing their jobs, are the people who have mortgages to pay, then that's a disaster for those Australians. So because the government is not doing its bit with fiscal policy, it just forces the Reserve Bank more and more to be heavy with monetary policy because it's the only tool they've got. I think we are in for more pain, and I think you can lay it squarely at the feet of the Prime Minister and the Treasurer, who just mouth words when you try to penetrate what they're saying. They're saying nothing at all. Believe us, we're great is about their mantra. So I think that the lack of leadership from Albanese is going to come back to haunt him, and he will be exposed for the failure of leadership he's always been. I've said before, I sat in that chamber with that man for 20 years plus, and nobody ever said he was leadership material.
Yeah.
And we're seeing the proof.
That's probably a surprise to him when he eventually got the prime ministership, and he's just grateful to be trotting all over the world without actually thinking that, oh, he's got to deliver on his promises. He promised 500 frontline workers. Well, he needs to deliver on them. Dave, I think, you know, Bronwyn brings up immigration, and I think the high immigration levels have technically kept us out of recession, although we have been in a per capita recession. So it seems like the overall economic data hides the fact that there are large sections of the Australian population that are really struggling with the cost of living.
Yeah, as you rightly point out, immigration is driving some GDP growth, but it is also fueling inflation, and that's what the Commonwealth Bank of Australia pointed out today. There's a number of factors under the government's control that are contributing to inflation. Record levels of migration, obviously. Failed energy policies that are pushing up power bills is another factor that the government can control that's fueling inflation. But most importantly, $209 billion in additional government spending and 19,000 new public servants as well. This is all fueling inflation. The government said in their first budget statement that the cash rate would peak at 3.35%. Since that time, we've had seven increases to the cash rate, and government policies have been contributing to those increases.
All right. Dave Hughes, Bronwyn Bishop, thank you both so much for your insights.